Hello, welcome. In this video, we are going to discuss an important problem in graph theory. It is called the Chinese Postman problem. First, we can discuss the Chinese Postman problem in its original form. The original problem is a postman wishes to pick his letters at his post office, at the post office, and he wants to deliver the letters along each street on his route and return to his post office to hand over all the undelivered letters there. He also wishes to do this job or to do his job with the minimum distance traveled. That would help him to conserve his energy. So that is the problem originally. In this is the problem, and then you know it has another version, a simplified version, but the problem is same. See that version. How can we cover all streets in a city and reach back at the starting point with minimum distance traveled? So this minimum distance traveled portion of the problem, it ensures that no edge or no street is repeatedly traversed. So repetition of traversal of the streets will be removed. That its possibility is removed using that condition, by imposing that condition. Now, you know, we have a graph theoretic version for this problem. Well, when we convert the problem, this is the real life problem, this problem can be converted into a graph model. It will be we can construct a weighted graph G, where each edge represents a street. Each edge in the graph represents a street in the route of the postman, and each vertex represents a junction in the city where two streets meet. See, each vertex in the graph will be, so we will, after that modeling, we will have a graph. In that graph, you know, vertices and edges are there. The meaning of vertices and edges in connection with that, when we link it with that with the Chinese postman problem, is explained here. Okay, the weight of the weight, it will be a weighted graph, you know, weight of each edge will get some weight. Now the weight of the edges joining two streets or joining two street represent the distance. Okay, joining the edge is there joining the graph, edges join two junctions, actually, you know, it's not streets. Streets are represented by edges. So weight of an edge means weight of that street. The weight of the street, that street joins two junctions in the graph. It represents the distance between the junctions. Yeah, it represents the weight of the, so weight of an edge in the graph represents the distance of the corresponding street, which joins two junctions in the city. So we define the weight of a tour. So we can correct it here, weight of the edges joining two junctions. So that correction can be made between two junctions. Okay, that's okay. Now then, we have the graphs has the sum. See, we define the weight of a tour, and after that we can define the weight of a tour. We are finding tours in the graph, which are present in the graph, and we can define the weight of a tour in the graph as the sum of the weights of the edges, sum of the weights of the edges which are present in the tour. So we are considering, if we are considering a tour, then edges are present on the tour, and those edges are weights. So you can add the weights of the edges which are present in the tour to obtain the weight of that tour. So CPP is just to find a tour having, just to find a tour having a a tour having a minimum weight in the graph. So a tour of G must be present at least a tour of G must be present at least once an edge. Yeah, there also we require a correction. The tour of G must be present. Each edge of G. Each edge of G must be present in at least must be present at least once in the tour. Okay, so see, each edge of G must be present exactly once, not at least once, exactly once, that you can correct exactly. Exactly, okay. Exactly once in the tour. Must be present exactly once in the tour. If there exists, because it must be present, every edge must be present at least once and not be present more than once. Okay, if there exists an Euler tour in the graph, that tour is the solution. If there is an Euler tour in the graph, then that tour will be the best solution, is the solution for the problem. If the same vertices are of odd degree, if some vertices in the graph are of odd degree, if some vertices in the graph are of odd degree, then we must duplicate the same edge, the corresponding edges. Some of the edges must be then in the graph must be duplicated to to get a complete an Euler tour. This problem will be there only if some of the vertices in the graph are of odd degree. Then what we have to do, to get an Euler tour, to make artificial Euler tour, you have to duplicate some edges. You have to trace back some edges which are present in the graph. What's mean by duplicating an edge in a graph? Idea must be defined properly. An edge in a graph is said to be duplicated in the graph. An edge in a graph is said to be duplicated in the graph if the ends of the edge are joined by another edge having the same edge weight. See, if the ends of the every edge has two ends. So if the two ends of the edge are joined by one more edge, if it is joined by another edge having the same edge weight. Now, Chinese postman problem in its original form, which is available in Wikipedia and in internet, it is it can be stated what is given here. Yeah, the Chinese postman problem asks for a shortest route over all edges of an edge-weighted graph. Over all edges of an edge-weighted graph, for graphs that have an Euler circle, for those graphs having an Euler cycle, that means for those graphs which are Eulerian, and this route obviously corresponds to the Euler circle which is present in that graph. But in other cases, in the case of other graphs, the edges must necessarily be traversed several times. The length of these edges must be minimized in those graphs which doesn't contain any Euler circle. We have to traverse some edges repeatedly. But why before selecting an edge to traverse it repeat more than once, you have to compare its weight with the other edges that also can equally be considered for traversal, for repeated traversal. So and then you have to select the edge having minimum weight. So that is the condition. If there exists many edges having this property which need to be traversed repeatedly, then there exists confusion. You have to decide which edge must be given preference for this repeated traversal. So that way you have to think more, and you have to compare many cases to obtain and to decide to to select a decision to conclude that to arrive before arriving at the conclusion. You have to think more. To do this, it is sufficient to find a smallest perfect. For that, you know, that is explained here. To do this, it is sufficient to find a smallest perfect pairing of the distance graph of all nodes with an Euler degree, and this creates a graph that has an Euler cycle or circle. It is now sufficient to find an Euler circle. After obtaining an Euler circle in that graph, then you can select an Euler circle, and you can that will give you the answer. See, with the use of using an example, using an example, we can explain the Chinese postman CPP. And Chinese postman problem has the short form CPP, all letters capitals. So the Chinese postman problem can be explained with the help of a figure. See, refer this figure. In this graph, in this figure, you can see that all vertices have even degree. Here, this vertex has 4 degree 4. It has 4 degree 2. This vertex has degree 4, this vertex also has degree 4, and this has degree 4, and okay, they are all the remaining vertices there exists one vertex having degree 2. Is there any other vertex having degree 2? No. But all the remaining vertices have degree 4. In other words, every vertex in the graph has a degree, even degree. Every vertex in the graph is of even degree. So it is clear that using our previous theorems, one of the previous theorems, we can conclude that this graph contains an Euler circuit or Euler cycle, and that Euler cycle can be given as an answer to the Chinese postman problem. So then, the weight of the, in such situation, weight of the weight of the edges in which are available or which are present in the graph doesn't matter. So there will be only one answer. So you can see the question. The definition of Euler tour is a closed work that traverses all the edges in a graph, and the problem is just a graph has an Euler tour. It's an easy problem. Our previously studied theorem says that it's an easy problem. The problem is to find a minimum Chinese postman tour. With reference to this figure, this graph, the problem can be solved because it contains an Euler tour that contains all the edges or all the all the streets in the, suppose, and this graph represents the main streets in a town which is to be traversed by the Chinese by the postman. So then definitely this graph has a solution. Coming to the second example 2, and here we have this is not the only case where we have to apply, we can think about applying that Chinese postman problem. Chinese postman problem can equally well be applied in the case of unweighted graphs. Unweighted graph case, we have discussed this unweighted graph cases, and as well as in the case of weighted graph. So we have one more problem which deals with unweighted graphs. So consider this is a simple graph compared to the previous graph which is given in example 1. In this graph there are only 4 vertices, and you can see that it's a complete graph because all edges are available in this graph. And the degree of each vertex is 3, and there are 4 vertices. We can see a path here drawn using arrow marks. You can go along this path Starting at the vertex 1, you can go to 2, then you can reach 4. After that, you can proceed to 3, then you can come to 1. But still, after it now completes that that one cycle, but you can see that still some edges are left there which are not traversed. So these are the two edges, these diagonal edges are still there to be traversed. So you have to go proceed along that line. And but when you reach the vertex 4, you can see all the edges. You have to come back to the starting vertex, that is the problem. But you can see there is no way to come back to the vertex 1 or so you have to choose one edge that you have already traversed. Therefore, either you can choose this way or you can come back this way, but you have to select an edge or a street. You have to select a street or equivalent. You can say that it's a street. You have to select either an edge or a street, comparing the length of that street with other possible options, with other possible cases of the streets having a specified length. But you know, in this case, all streets have the same length because it's an unweighted graph. Here it is assumed that all edges have same weight. That means all streets have same distance. Okay. All streets have same length, and then you have to choose either this line or this line. Here you can see this line is chosen, and then when you reach 3, you are you can then that untraced edge is then selected. Thus you are lead to that it leads to the vertex 2, and finally you can once again you have to trace the edge between 1 and 2 to get back to the starting vertex 1. So this way you get an Euler trail, but it's an artificially created Euler trail in which some edges have duplicated. What are the edges that are duplicated here in this graph in order to get the Euler tour? Here, to get the Euler tour, we have duplicated the edge between 1 and 2 and the edge between 3 and 4 that you can see. Two times this edge is, this line is traversed. Here also this edge is, this line is traversed two times. So you can thus you can see here the path, the Euler trail which is selected in this graph. See, the main problem associated with this graph, which does not in the first instance it does not generate an Euler tour, is that the degree of the vertices in the graph are all odd, and that is the problem. So in order to overcome that problem, you have to consider duplication of edges. So this duplication of edge, by giving duplication of edges, by adding one more edge between 3 and 4 and doing the same thing between 1 and 2, you can make the degree of all the vertices in the graph equal to 4, and thus we get all vertices in the graph having even degree. And that helps us to find an Euler tour in the modified graph, in the new graph. So that is, and thus we have explained in detail the concept of edge duplication in a graph. And this edge duplication is used to obtain an Euler tour in Chinese Postman problem. Coming to the example 3, we can see a weighted graph. You can see a weighted graph. So finding an Euler tour in a weighted graph is the problem. But if the weighted graph is an Euler graph, then that choice for an Euler trail is there unique. You have a unique Euler tour that you can find in the graph. So there is no chance of getting different answers. Finally, you will get a single value for the sum of the edge weights on the Euler tour. But suppose that the graph is not an Euler graph, that means some vertices have old degree in the graph, then you have to select the vertices, pairs of vertices which have old degree in the graph for adding edges or for edge duplication. So this this edge duplication, this act of edge duplication will lead to the situation of different pairs of vertices being available for selection, for choice. So that will give different cases. After we having different cases, you have to find the total edge weight of the corresponding tour in each, considering each case separately, and then finally you have to compare the total of the edge weights and to get the decision, or to take the decision that which tour is the best one, or the which, or in other words, which tour has the minimum edge weight, and that will be the answer to the problem. So that is explained here, you know, that kind of situation is explained here in this weighted graph. You can see that one of the solution is given here. It is starting, you can see the Euler trail is, Euler tour is explained here. From you begin at the vertex 1, then 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, 3, 4, 2, 0, 1, 0 to 1, and that is the that is the Euler tour that is artificially created after duplicating edges, and you can find the total of the edge weight here. Okay, and you have to, but this may not be the right answer. You have to find all the possible cases of Euler tours artificially that can be created in the graph, and then you have to find its edge weights, and finally you have to compare the values and decide. You have to, and then you can take a decision based on the minimum value of the sum of the edge weights that you are going to get. Our next example, the graph. When we think about the graph theoretic solution of this problem, if the graph is Eulerian, you can conclude that if the graph is Eulerian, then the Euler tour in the graph is the solution to the Chinese postman problem. If there is no Euler tour in the graph, then we have to create an Euler tour by duplicating some edges and keeping the total edge weight in the tour a minimum. See, the finally we have another example, another picture here, and in this network, this is the network of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices, and the street connecting or edge connecting these vertices are also available here, and a path can be selected in this graph here. Starting, suppose you start at the vertex E, then we are starting at the vertex suppose we start at the vertex the vertex A to B, then to B here, according to the arrow marks shown here in the along the side of near the edges. Arrow mark is given that indicates the path that we select. So we start at the vertex A, and then we reach B, and then we reach C. After that we reach D, then you go you go further to E, and then we come back to A, we reach A. After that you take this path, the edge 1 is then selected to reach D, but by that you have completed, you have selected all the edges in the graph exactly once you have selected, but there is no way to reach back to. That is the problem here. After selecting all the edges in the graph, or all the streets in the city exactly one, there is no way to reach back to your starting point. The starting point is A, so you have to consider the path, or at least one of the path or one of the street to get back to reach back to your origin of your travel. Okay, and that is A here, the point A here. For that you can select the edge 1 or the street 1. So that means you have to retry you have to trace back that street exactly one time, one more time. You have to consider that street to travel. So that is given here as the duplication of the edge. So adding that edge to the existing path that we have selected, you can complete that Euler tour. Okay, that is the answer to this problem. Okay, thank you. Thank you for listening.